Now, a nice example of social behavior's variability is illustrated by the behavior of different rodents that are sometimes called polygamous and monogamous rodents. These are two different kinds of rodents. They're called voles, and if you encountered them, they would look very similar to you, as shown by these different kinds of photographs. But if you examine their behaviors, you would see that these animals had really different social strategies. Meadow voles are what are called polygamous voles. These voles are largely solitary in their lifestyle. They, single males and females, will mate briefly and then scatter. There's very limited maternal care of offspring and no paternal care at all. And they also differ in other social behaviors. They're not territorial and they're not aggressive. By comparison, prairie voles are voles that will form pair bonds that will last for the entire life of a male and a female after a single mating. They live in large colonies. The mothers take very good care of the pups, and so do the fathers. They show paternal care of their offspring. In addition to their pair bonding, they also show territorial and aggressive behavior, distinguishing those within their own group from those of other groups. So these closely related rodents provide a way to think about what kinds of genetic changes might evolve to allow these two different species to have such different social behaviors. And that has been the mission of Tom Insel, Larry Young, and their colleagues at Emory University. What they found is that these differences in social behaviors were related to the functions of other important neuropeptides in the mammalian brain. In mammals, social behavior is regulated by two neuropeptides that are related to each other called oxytocin and vasopressin. Oxytocin is strongly implicated in maternal behaviors as well as certain forms of maternal physiology like nursing. Vasopressin is related to male behaviors. So each of these peptides exists in the brain. Each of them has its own specialized receptors that exist them, that detect them. What is the difference between polygamous voles and monogamous voles in these systems that allows them to behave differently? Well, both polygamous and monogamous voles have oxytocin and vasopressin, and both have receptors for oxytocin and vasopressin. So it's not the existence of these genes that differs. Instead, it's the way these genes are deployed in the brain that's different in species that show different behaviors. The difference between monogamous and polygamous voles comes when you examine the vasopressin and oxytocin receptors in the brains of these animals and look at where in the brains these receptors are deployed. So this slide here shows sections through the brains of a monogamous vole and a polygamous vole. These are both males, and they're sections at the same location of the brain. The bright colors, the greens and reds and yellows, illustrate locations at which the vasopressin V1 receptor is being expressed. And what's evident from looking at this is that while both of these species have the vasopressin receptor, they utilize the vasopressin receptor in different brain regions. The monogamous vole, shown at top, expresses the vasopressin receptor in regions that are involved in reward, and the rewarding presence of this receptor helps the vole to generate what you might think of as a positive association with its mate that promotes the formation of a pair bond. The polygamous vole, shown at bottom, does express a vasopressin receptor, but it expresses it in different brain regions that would not allow this animal to form a rewarding memory. And so the utilization of these receptors in different brain regions causes different kinds of associations to be built and different behaviors to result.